Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Now let's continue with the budgeted income statement. We have already seen all this, the operating budgets, and now we prepare the last one is the budgeted income statement, right? So for the budgeted income statement, so you it is important because that is the end product of your operating budgets. Okay, you can see here. So that is the end product of your operating budgets, right? Then it indicates the expected profitability of your operations. You want to know whether you are making profit or losses. So it shows the expected profitability of your operations. And then it provides a basis for evaluating the company's performance. How do you prepare the budgeted income statement? So it is prepared from your operating budgets just now, from your sales, direct material, direct labor, manufacturing of it, selling and admin expenses. You can see here. So that budgeted income statement is prepared from your sales, all this one, right? So from there, you will come out with your budgeted income statement. Okay, and then for example, to find the cost of goods sold, Hays company must first determine the total unit cost of producing one right bicycle seat as shown. Okay, before you can prepare the budgeted income statement, you first need to determine the total unit cost. How much is the cost per unit, okay, of your product? How to determine that? So you will have your direct material. Remember the cost element. You have your direct material, your direct labor, and your manufacturing overhead. Okay, this one. So you want to know how much is your direct material, your direct labor, and your manufacturing overhead. Now you want to determine how much is the cost per unit for your right. Okay, per unit, right? So how do you prepare it? So for your direct material, the quantity that you require to produce one unit is 2 kilogram. How do you get that figure, the 2 kilograms? You can refer to your illustration 9.9. Remember when we prepare the direct material budget given in the question that each unit produced requires 2 kilograms of raw materials. So you require 2 kilograms. So this one you will have for your direct materials, you require 2 kilograms. And then cost per unit given in the question just now is 4 ringgit per unit of per kilogram. So that would give you 2 times 4 gives you 8. That is the total cost, right? And then work out for your direct labor. For your direct labor, you require 2 hours and the cost per hour is 10 ringgit. How do you get this information? Again, you can refer to your direct labor budget that we have prepared earlier at illustration 9.11. So if you remember the one that we have done, 2 hours of direct labor are required to produce each unit of your finished goods. Okay, and then the wage rate is 10 ringgit per hour. So that's how we get this one for your direct labor, the quantity that you require to produce one unit. This one for one you require 2 hours of direct labor, and the cost is 10 ringgit per hour. So the total cost would be 10 times 2 gives you 20. And then what about the manufacturing overhead? This one refer to your illustration 9.12 for your manufacturing overhead, right? So we have done our manufacturing overhead budget previously. So we've seen that the total manufacturing overhead cost that we incur is 246,400 ringgit, okay, for the year. And then that is based on the total direct labor hours of 3,800. So 30,800 hours, and the cost is 246,400 ringgit. So now you work out your manufacturing overhead cost per direct labor hour. So that would be 246,400 divided by 30,800. Okay, 246,400 divided by 30,800. So that will give you 8 ringgit per direct labor hour. So, and then remember, you work out, you need for each unit, you require 2 direct labor hours. So that would be, so 2 hours times 8 ringgit per unit. So you will get 16 ringgit in total. So to produce one product, that means one right that you need, you produce. So you require 8 ringgit. The cost is 8 ringgit for your direct material, 20 ringgit for your direct labor, and 16 ringgit for your manufacturing overhead. So you total that up. That means the component, the cost element. So to produce one unit, so one unit of this product, the cost is 44 ringgit. Okay, the cost is 40, 4 ringgit. That is the total unit cost or total cost per unit of one, right? Right. Okay. After you have done that, the second step is for you to determine the cost of goods sold. So the cost of goods sold by multiplying the unit sold times the unit cost. So in this case, you will have 15,000 units times the 44. This one, you have worked out the 44 ringgit per unit. And then how many units that you sell? In total, you have sold 15,000 units. Okay, how do you get this figure? Remember your sales budget just now? The expected units is 15,000 units and the value is 900,000. So you get from here 15,000 units, right? So you will get 15,000 units times 44 ringgit per unit. You will get 660,000 ringgit. Next, you prepare your budgeted income statement. So all the data from the income statement come from the operating budgets, except the following. Now you have the given in the question, additional information, your interest expense 100 and your income tax 12,000. So this is how you prepare your budgeted income statement. So for the year ending December 31st, 2022, so you have your sales just now we have seen 900,000 ringgit in total. And then what about your cost of goods sold? You already work out here just now the cost of goods sold, 15,000 units times 44, you will get 660,000. So that gives you 660,000. So that will give you a gross profit of 240, 900 minus 660. Okay, so this one is your revenue, this one is your cost. Okay, revenue minus your cost give you your gross profit of 240. Now you deduct all other costs besides your cost of goods sold. So you already calculated your selling and administrative expenses just now, 180,000. So this one go to your selling and administrative expense budget. So this one, your selling and administrative expense budget, the total is 180,000. So you take from here, so the figure of 180,000. So 240 minus your selling and admin, 180,000, that gives you 60,000. So that is known as your income from operations. Okay, income from operations or profit from operations is 60,000. And then you less your interest expense. Where do you get the 100? Given in the question, the additional information that the interest expense is expected to be 100 ringgit. So you minus 100 ringgit. So that gives you 59,900. That is known as the income before income taxes. Okay, income before income taxes. And then deduct your income tax expense. Given in the question, your income taxes are estimated to be 12,000 ringgit. So 59,900 minus 12,000 ringgit. So that will give you your net income of 47,900 ringgit. So that's how you prepare your budgeted income statement, right? So this one is the gross figure and this one is the net figure. Gross means you just take your total, the cost of that particular product. Okay, so the cost of that particular product will be your cost of material, cost of your labor, and cost of your overheads. But there are also other costs that you incur, your selling and admin, your interest, and your income taxes. So that will give you your net income or net profit for the company. That's how you prepare your budgeted income statement. Okay, hopefully you have a better understanding on this one. Okay, just try to answer this question. Each of the following budgets is used in preparing the budgeted income statement except the sales budget, selling and administrative budget, capital expenditure budget, or direct labor budget. So if you see here to prepare your budgeted income statement, so you require your sales budget, you require your selling and admin budget, and you require your direct labor budget, but you do not need your capital expenditure budget. Okay, capital expenditure budget is for your financial budget, not for your operating budgets, right? So to answer this question, the answer is the capital expenditure budget, right? Okay, with that, I thank you. Hopefully you have a better understanding on this topic, right?